एक्चुअली वी आर राइटिंग फॉर डायलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट, एप्सिलॉन आर वी आर राइटिंग फॉर द रिलेटिव परमिटिविटी, बोथ टर्म्स आर सेम. तो देयरफॉर एप्सिलॉन आर इज इक्वल टू एप्सिलॉन बाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट, एप्सिलॉन बाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट. नाउ वी कैन डिफाइन रिलेटिव परमिटिविटी. रिलेटिव परमिटिविटी इज द रेशियो ऑफ व्हाट? एब्सोल्यूट परमिटिविटी ऑफ द मीडियम टू द परमिटिविटी ऑफ द फ्री स्पेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ परमिटिविटी. अनदर वे ऑल्सो वी कैन राइट रिलेटिव परमिटिविटी इज द रेशियो बिटवीन द फोर्स बिटवीन द चार्जेस इन free space to the force between the charges in the medium. Now from that epsilon is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. Force in the medium q1 into q2 by r square. This one we have done. So then what happened? This can be written as 4 pi epsilon naught epsilon r into q1 into q2 by r square. Now again, in free space, force between two charges, we have written what? F is equal to, for free space, F equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r square. If each charges r is equal to q1 is equal to q2 equal to 1 coulomb, r is equal to 1 meter, and force acting, no, 1 meter, then F is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9. These two terms, this one will be 1, so 9 into 10 to the power 9, what is? Newton. The force between the charges will be 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton, because already we know 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton per meter square, meter square per coulomb square. Is it? Now next topic is concept of electric field. Concept of electric field. So what is electric field? Electric field is a space around or region around a stationary charge where an electric charge will experience force. Say this is a point charge. It will create what? Electric field around it. This is a space. Beyond this space, there is no effect of this charge. Is it? It will keep a charge over here. Say this is positive charge. Okay, so therefore this is known as source charge. And we are testing here by using a charge, very small charge. Yes, so therefore this charge will feel some force due to this one. But beyond the field, there is no any force. So that an electric field is a region where electric charge experiences a force. Now, electric intensity, that is amount of field, electric intensity. This is denoted by E, capital E, and it is vector quantity. If Q naught be a test charge, okay, if Q naught be a test charge, we are testing this one in electric field due to charged body, say A. This is charged body, say it is A. A charge is kept here, that is say Q naught. Okay. So then electric intensity due to charge body A on the test charge Q naught will be E is equal to F by Q naught. Okay. Magnitude way we can write E is equal to F by Q naught. Or simply we can say electric intensity is force per unit charge. Force per unit charge. Now, here, the unit of electric intensity will be what? Newton per coulomb. Newton per coulomb, or also we'll use volt per meter. Also we'll use volt per meter. Now, this is source charge. Charge on it, say it is Q. If we'll bring the test charge, and we are making this one, it is containing large amount of charge. Okay, then what happened? Say it is, now Q naught is, say it is Q naught dash is greater than what? Q naught. Then the charge distribution on A will be redistributed. It will be changed. Due to that, field due to source charge will be now different than the previous one. So that intensity will change. So therefore, now we'll change our this one, that is equal to F by Q naught. Previous definition will change, is it? previous definition will change now little. Now we'll here mention that the test charge must be taken which will not disturb the charge distribution on the source charge. Is it? So then we'll say then we'll say what? The electric intensity at a point is now defined as the force acting on a test charge, force acting on a test charge placed at that point when the test charge approaches zero or very, very small, which will not affect. It means when test charge is Q naught, then what happen? E vector is equal to limit Q naught tends to zero. Means test charge is now very, very small, approaches zero. F by Q naught, where F is the force on the test charge due to the source charge. And also keep in mind the value of Q naught must not less than what? This is the minimum one. One electron. Is it? Now also uniform and non-uniform electric intensity. Electric intensity also simply it is known as electric field also. Okay. The uniform or non-uniform electric field, if the magnitude and direction of the electric intensity remains constant throughout in a certain region, the field is said to be uniform. And non-uniform, if the magnitude or the direction or both of the electric field varies from point to point, then the electric field is said to be non-uniform. Generally, uniform electric field we are marking by using the equally spaced parallel lines. This way, uniform field we are showing. And non-uniform electric field may be shown by this way. This way. These are non-uniform. The parallel lines, equally spaced, are uniform. Now, direction of electric intensity. This is main one. Generally, whenever we are saying that is test charge, we are saying unit positive charge. Is it? Say, this is a point charge. Say it is Q kept at A, a point we are considering P, and distance at a distance small r. If it is positive charge plus Q, if it is plus Q, and here we kept unit positive charge.